Ashoka, the beloved of the gods.
Devanam Priya Priyadarshi Samrat Ashok was one of the greatest kings of the world. In the entire history of the world, there is no other emperor like him. Historians of India and Europe agree on this. H. E. Wells, a great scholar, historian, and writer, said, "The name of Ashok shines, and shines almost alone a star." Ashok was unique because he was the greatest and most powerful emperor of his time, but renounced the use of force when he was at the peak of his power. He made nonviolence the policy of his government and devoted himself to spreading peace. He ruled over an empire which was greater than modern India. It spread over the entire Indian subcontinent and to the east and west beyond the Himalayas. Yet the message he gave to his subjects was, "The only true conquest is the conquest of men's hearts by Dhamma, Dharam, or moral law." Ashok was the third king of the Mauryan dynasty. He came to the throne in 268 BC and inherited the empire. In Ashok's time, Buddhism was a young and energetic religion. It is said that as a young man, Ashok was very cruel. He got angry very easily and ordered many killings in fits of anger. At the same time, there were strong Buddhist influences working on him. His wife, the daughter of a merchant of Vidisha, was a firm believer in Buddha's principles of love and peace. Many times she made him promise that he would not be violent. In spite of these promises, Ashok continued to kill and wage wars. Another great influence was of his young nephew Nigrodh, who was his brother Suman's son. It is believed that Ashok got his brother Suman killed in order to become the king. He thought Nigrodh would be full of hatred for him. But young Nigrodh had become a Buddhist monk at a very young age and had no bitterness or hatred in his heart against Ashok. The boy's nobility and forgiveness touched Ashok's heart. The turning point in Ashok's life came with the Kalinga War. It brought about a change of heart in him. Ashok wanted to extend his empire to east and south and therefore attacked Kalinga, modern Odisha. Like all wars, it ended in a huge loss of life. 100,000 people were killed, 150,000 made prisoners, and many more suffered. The horror of such destruction filled Ashok's heart with deep sorrow. He vowed not to take any more lives. He vowed to work to bring happiness and peace. He became a Buddhist and set about spreading his message with great enthusiasm. Ashok appointed officials to see that his message reached the people. More than 2,000 years ago, he had the large-heartedness to be tolerant of non-Buddhists. His messages were carved on huge rocks and pillars. These rocks and pillars were installed all over his kingdom. The rock edicts and Ashokan pillars can be seen even today. His workers and craftsmen gave the stones a glass-like polish which shines even today. Some of Ashok's messages are: 1. We should respect our parents, teachers, and elders. 2. We should be kind to animals. 3. We should speak the truth. 4. No living creature should be killed. 5. People should be generous and give in charity. Such messages make up Ashok's Dhamma or Dharam. They teach people how to bring happiness to all living creatures. These messages are in Ashok's own words. Ashok took many steps to spread Buddhism. He sent his son Mahendra and daughter Sangamitra to Sri Lanka on the request of Devampriya Tissa, the king of Sri Lanka. He sent a branch of the Bodhi tree to that country, where it was planted with great reverence. His religious ambassadors travelled all over his empire and beyond. It was largely due to his efforts that Buddhism spread to distant countries such as Ceylon, Sri Lanka, Burma, Myanmar, Thailand, China, Japan, also to countries of Central Asia. Ashoka's title was Devanampriya, or Beloved of the Gods. He ruled for almost 40 years. The effect of his teachings can be seen on Indian life even today. The government of India has adopted our national symbols from Ashoka's pillars. The wheel or the chakra is in our flag. The four lions sitting back to back are from the top of Ashoka's pillar at Sarnath, which Ashoka erected to honor the place where Lord Buddha preached his first sermon.